Good morning, children. So the first video I have already sent you, and this is the second video, the diseases and the first aid. So now in this video, we are going to discuss about the vaccination. What is vaccination, how it is given, when it is given. So this type of things we are going to discuss. Now first is that the idea of vaccination, it is discovered by Edward. It is given over here, that is, it is discovered by Edward Jenner. It is discovered by Edward Jenner, and which year? 1749 to 1823, in between that timing, the idea of vaccination was discovered by Edward Jenner. So he has discovered about the vaccination. Now how he has discovered? He observed that milkmaids were in contact with the cows suffering from cowpox. Okay, milkmaids, those who sell the milk, they are in contact with the cow, and those cows, they are suffering from cowpox. And when the cows, they are suffering from cowpox, they never get smallpox. So he is tested this history on the 8-year-old boy. What he has done? He got the material taken from cowpox and introduced it into the body, boy's body. Okay, and the boy's body developed pustules, which later on formed a scab and healed, leaving a scar. Okay, what he has done? He has taken some of the material from the body of the cow who is suffering from cowpox, and he introduced that into the body of a boy. Boy has got some pustules, means some rashes on the body, and it was just like a scrab on the body, and after that it was healed. And he has injected the smallpox virus into the body of that boy. Now the no sign of smallpox arises into the body of that boy. So he used the term vaccination for that. And the vaccine for that, and the term is vaccination, that is used by him. So he has got the idea that this vaccination, if we introduce the germs of cowpox inside the body of any person, then the person doesn't suffer from smallpox. So he has made the vaccine, which was introduced into the body, and the person will not get the disease. Second is Louis Pasteur. So he has also developed many vaccination like anthrax, chickenpox, cholera. These are the germs. Against those germs, he has introduced many vaccinations. So now what is a vaccination? Definition of vaccination. So vaccination, it is a simply practice of artificially introducing the germs or the germ substance into the body by developing resistance to a particular disease. So this practice is called prophylaxis, in which we introduce the germs from the body of the infected person to the another person to develop the resistance, and the material that we introduce, that is called vaccine. So two things are there. One is the prophylaxis, so it is a practice, and the material is called vaccine. So remember that. What is prophylaxis and what is vaccine? Now usually the vaccine or the germ substance is introduced into the body by the injections. Nowadays also the small children, they get the vaccination of BCG, hepatitis. So it was introduced in the body with the help of injections. Now sometime it is given orally, like the polio drop. Polio drop is given to the children below the age of 5. So when the vaccine is injected into the body, it stimulates WBCs and produces antibodies against the germs. So the term vaccine or the vaccination was originally used only for the vaccination against the smallpox. Later on, many vaccination have developed, and nowadays, now we can see nowadays also there is a preparation of vaccination for coronavirus also. So the doctors, they are the scientists, they are preparing that vaccination, that when it is introduced into the body, it will not cause any other type of harm. Only it protects the body against those viruses, particular viruses. So a vaccination is prepared by any one of the following method. First is by using a killed germs. So like typhoid, stack vaccine for poliomyelitis and the vaccine for rabies. So what they do? They use the germs, they kill those germs, and then those germs will be introduced into the body through injections. Another thing, by using the living weakened germs. So weakened germs which are not very strong, so those germs, they become, when they become very weak, they are introduced into the body and they can induce antibody formation in the body. So the vaccination of measles, tuberculosis, they are also prepared by using a living weakened, which are not very strong, but when they enter inside the body, they become strong. So such type of vaccination is prepared. The third type is using fully relevant living organisms. So in this vaccination, the germs, in this vaccination, the persons, they are inoculated with the cowpox virus. Means fully the grown living organisms, they are taken from the person and then they are introduced. So in first one, we are using the killed germs, second the less weak germs, and third is the fully virulent living organisms. So these are some of the ways by which we make the vaccine. Now fourth is also given here, over here. This is using a toxics. So what is toxics? So toxics, they are the extracts taken, okay, from other organisms. So they are maybe secreted by bacteria. So these toxins, toxins means they are just like a poison, okay. But when they are entered inside the body, they start producing the antibodies. So when they are introduced into the body, the harmful substances, so when they are introduced into the body, they are going to help the body by producing the immunity against the body. So this type of attempts already were being taken to develop the vaccination against AIDS, but it is mostly it is not successful. Now the next topic that we are going to take is the immunization. Now what is immunization? Immunization is when we have taken the vaccination.